Hi, I'm Kirk Nolan. Welcome to The Box. The psychopath's strategy for destroying the object of their wrath is to first put the person on a pedestal. It isn't enough to take away what she has. The victim must also feel a tremendous amount of loss. One psychopath said, "When I want to destroy someone first, I like to make them happy. I like to make them really high because that way they have further to fall." In 1964, well-known psychoanalyst Eric Fromm first coined the term malignant narcissism. He described it as a severe mental sickness, which embodied the quintessence of evil. My life was burnt down to the ground by psychopathic monsters who surrounded me in a hyenic way. I mean, they were just nipping at me left and right. You are living in it. And because you're living in it, you can't see the trauma bonding that has occurred in your life that causes you to embrace these same psychopathic archetypes. I mean, I was birthed by a psychopath. I married a psychopath. All of these traits just kept folding over into my life again and again and again. They're just trauma buttons pushed on me that just would be pushed and I just wouldn't even realize it, like some of you are doing right now. You don't even realize it. There are a lot of people saying the words, "I don't really understand why I want him back. I don't really understand why I have to be in her arms. I don't understand why after all the abuse, all the pain, all the hatred, all the chaos that they've caused my life, somehow I can't let go of them. I can't let go of it." This is the sickness. This is the insidious sickness that gets into your blood that is very hard for you to recognize and shake when it comes to these pathological monsters.
Gaslighting, it is a sociopathic behavior, but that doesn't mean they're gonna go out or have the potential to go out and kill somebody, rape somebody. It's more of a emotional, sociopathic behavior, if you will, not so much of the physical aspect. And it turns into the verbal abuse, and they're very good at manipulating other people, friends, family member, and the thinking, even your own family members. If you're being gaslit, your own family members, your own friends, they will try to manipulate them into taking their side. Yeah, she's crazy.
Oh, so that was going to be my next question. So a gaslighter could bring in a group of people into that same thing.
They're pros at it.
But actually, I have a line that I've used over the years, which is just because you formed a posse doesn't make you right.
Correct, right?
Because people can be grabbed together on a false idea, a false premise.
And it's the mob mentality, right? Everybody in the mob is right. That one person is wrong. Not necessarily.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand?
Right.
And a lot of people don't get that. And they look at, because of, you know, we talked about this before, because of the numbers. That doesn't make all those numbers right in one person wrong.
Right. Just because you form a posse doesn't make you right.
Absolutely.
Evil. Just plain, unadulterated evil. That's what narcissists are. They will use your children as weapons against you. Some of you are just starting to head down that road right now. You're starting to realize what you've gotten yourself into. It's not your fault. If you had known it earlier, you would have prevented it, but you didn't. And so now, you are now trapped in this war now that is going to continue on for generations. And you have to start preparing yourself for it. You have to start putting on some battle armor and getting ready for it. You're not just seeing it in your own family, you're seeing it around the world. Look at it. It is a war. And the pathological, psychopathic narcissists are in control. They will use everything in their power to line their pockets, to get what they want, and all the time telling people, "You don't know what you're talking about. Oh, we didn't do that. We didn't say that." They lie. They're liars. They're cheaters. They're just plain evil. There is no other word for it.
One of the greatest philosophers of our time, Noam Chomsky, stated you can't even begin to find a word in the English language that describes the kind of evil that these people perpetrate upon humanity simply to line their pockets or to gain more power. That's all it is about. Control over other human beings. And when they feel they can't control you, then they will find some way to do that. And my mistake was I allowed the monster in my life to realize what was most important to me, my own child. That was it. A child she did not even want. A child she was ready to give up for money, a house. But when she found out that the thing I wanted and the thing I cared about the most was my little girl, that's the weapon she used against me for the rest of my life. And days. And my child's days. She has tortured us both to the place of losing our minds. My own child holding scissors to her neck, threatening to kill herself, and then being institutionalized by the same monster who gaslit her and brought her to that place. That's why it's no wonder to watch decades later, my only child, motionless, sad, pathetic, following along and doing the bidding of the monster that has dominated and controlled her life for so long and never allowed her one moment of free thought on her own. This is what they will do. This is what these monsters will do. Stop listening to people telling you that, oh, eventually your child will figure out the end. No, they won't. If your child is surrounded by pathological narcissists like mine was, and will use that child in every way they can and scapegoat you to the gates of hell and continue to do it even after you have figured out a way to come back out of that, they will continue to try to scapegoat you. Look around. The whole world is being gaslit now. The whole world is being sent down the road to the abyss. So listen to people who are telling you to run. Get away from these monsters as fast as you can. Because if you don't, you will continue to pay for the rest of your life watching your children embrace these same monstrous qualities that we are now seeing is destroying the world.